Hello, welders. Today, I've got a quick video for you demonstrating how to hook up the power supply and the wire feeder on the ESAB Cobot system. That's going to be the Aristo 500iX and RobustFeed U82, respectively. Let's get into the demonstration. So this is how our Cobot system comes packaged. These cables are more or less going to be tucked away. And what we're going to do is we're going to sort of unpackage them and get them connected. So the first connection that we're going to go ahead and take care of is our connection cable. And what this is doing is this is hooking up our Aristo 500iX to the RobustFeed U82. It's a communications cable. And as you can see, there is a slot there and there's a tab here, and we want to make sure that that slot aligns with the tab, and then we're going to tighten it with this. I'm just going to go ahead and plug that in. And turn clockwise until that is tight. Next up, we're going to have our positive welding terminal, and again, that has a tab in the 6 o'clock position, and what we're going to do is we're just going to plug that into the slot, and we're going to turn that clockwise as well. Give that a pull, and that's plugged in. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing with our negative return cable. Now I will say that there might be some instances of using a shielded flux core gasless wire, right? And with that, you might be running that DC electrode negative, but you are going to want to consult your data sheet for that consumable to make sure that that's correct. But anyways, we're going to go ahead and we're going to plug this in and turn that clockwise. Give everything a good, just reassuring, just making sure everything's plugged in and our power system is connected to our wire feeder. Let's go get some drive rolls installed and some wire going through our system. So now that our power source and our wire feeders are connected, what we can do is we can go ahead and get our drive rolls installed, our wire installed, and we can even set our gas flow rate in the RobustFeed as well. It has a built-in flow meter. So using the toolless design, I'm going to get my drive rolls on there. So what I can do is each of these black knobs, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn these all to the left and make sure that the black tabs are aligned with the yellow tabs. I'm just going to go ahead and turn these all to the left. And now I'm going to flip down my roller pressure levers. And up top in our door, there is a compartment that holds the drive rolls. There are also charts on the inside of the door to show which type of drive roll to use. How much roller pressure to use per your wire size and type. I'm going to be using 035 solid core steel wire, so I'm going to be using V groove 035 sized drive rolls. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and slide these on, and I want the color and the number facing me. I'm just going to go ahead and slide all these on, like so. Cool. And then I can just close these, flip up my levers, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn all these to the left. And now my drive rolls are locked in. Let's get some wire in this wire feeder. Now that my drive rolls are installed, I'm going to go ahead and install my wire. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take my cap and I'm going to loosen that and just take that off completely. Cool.
and then I'm gonna grab my spool of wire, and this hole here, you want that to line up with this little notch here on the inside of the feeder, and you want your wire to be coming counterclockwise down into the drive rolls there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slot this on, and you can see that's not going anywhere because the tab is in the hole correctly. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to tighten my cap, screw that on just to where it's snug enough. Hold my wire in place. Here's where you're gonna adjust the attention for your wire feeder if need be. So now what I'm gonna do is you wanna do this very carefully because you don't want your wire to unwind and lose slack. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my drive rolls, open those up, and I've got my fingers on the inside of this here, and I'm holding this because I really don't want to lose that tension. I'm going to take my welpers, cut that, and now I'm just sort of feeding this through, and you really want to maintain the tension on that. And I'm feeding this wire through my outlet and my inlet guides. And you really want to use two hands for this because you do not want to mess this up. So now that my wire is being fed through all my guides, I can go ahead and bring this down. And my wire is ready to be fed through the system. So once the wire is ready to be fed through, on the pendant for the U82, there's an option called wire inch, and we're gonna press and hold that in order to jog wire through our torch. And we're gonna do that until wire comes out the end of the torch. Awesome. As previously mentioned, the RobustFeed U82 does have a built-in flow meter. So to utilize that to the best of its ability, on your gas cylinder, you can install either another flow meter or a pressure meter. And what I've done is I have a pressure meter on my cylinder, is you want to set that to 50 to 60 PSI. And then what we can do is on the U82 pendant, we can press gas purge. And then we can set on our flow meter. I've got that at about 35 CFH. And if you're using a flow meter on your cylinder, so you have a flow meter on the cylinder and the flow meter here, you're gonna wanna set that to like 5 to 10 CFH above what you're setting it at here, just to account for the pressure drop over the course of, you know, the gas's movements, right? So that covers gas, that covers drive rolls, and that covers wire installation. One last consideration is to make sure that this REM remote option on your U82 pendant is highlighted. What this does is this allows you, this allows the wire feeder to communicate with the app, and that's sort of like the whole deal, right? Is we want to be able to use the app to control our settings. Make sure this is pressed, make sure that's highlighted in order for that to work properly.
Welders, now that your power source and wire feeder are connected and powered and wire installed, you're ready to weld. Have a great day, and remember, keep it simple. Cobot. Thank you for watching.